Statistics. So descriptive, okay. A simple, in a very simple meaning, English word. What does descriptive means to you? When I say descriptive, what does it mean?
Like every action speaks in a manner you will analyze it. Yeah, this is in every steps.
Yep. Anything else? People online, do you have any answer? Okay. So statistics is basically defined on, basically there are two ideas. Okay. One is descriptive. Another is inferential. So we will kind of look at both one by one. Descriptive is like, okay, which tells about data. Okay. Inferential would be which helps us infer mathematical truth. Okay. Now, both of these branches, like, okay, you have to understand, and people keep asking me this. So statistics is about anyways, like description anyways. It tells you like, okay, so descriptive will tell you, okay, this is what it is. From inferential, you can know some mathematical truth. Okay. So one of the, okay, what is this? You guys have must have done some statistics if you were from engineering or something at any point. So what kind of statistics that you got, guys got to solve? Or like, what was the purpose of statistics, or why it was being taught?
To find out the maximum, which is the main area.
Okay.
Where
main area, okay.
Where the amount, in case of mechanical impact, right. We'll say like normal distribution is there.
Yes.
So in particular fixed particular region, this amount of can consider as a accepted part. Apart from that, we can consider as a rejected part.
Makes sense. Okay. Yeah, so basically these things that you read is, okay. Basically, the idea of descriptive statistics is we have to summarize the information, okay? Ever became very curious and, okay, so when the budget of India is basically presented, almost within a day or within 24 hours, it is also put on Government of India's website as well. Have you ever opened that and have tried to have a look at it? You should do that. It's a very fun exercise. Okay. So you can understand the spending, expenditure, and how government makes money and everything. But then you will realize something, that if you did not have descriptive statistics, it is impossible to represent this much data, maybe within 200 pages. Because you understand the budget of India is a very big deal. Still online, you can find like what? 200, 300 pages, and our budget is there. So without descriptive statistics, it's impossible. You possibly cannot represent that much data that India is collecting and try to even possibly represent that in like maybe less than 300 pages or so. Okay, so basically by summarizing information, descriptive statistics speed up and simplify comprehension of a group characteristics. And this is the biggest topic, I guess. The idea is comparing each one individually is very hard after a while. You will realize this problem. Okay. So the idea is for this whole group, what characteristics can I think about? Okay. Sorry. Why is this? That's okay. One definition first, or at least you should know this. What is a population and what is a sample?
Mm-hmm.
But let's define population, then define sample. What is population?
Population is like every information you have, A to Z from start. If you're selling a sample data.
Sorry?
Selling over the data, like descriptive form.
No, but what is population? In statistics, what do we mean by population? When we say population, in statistics, what does it really mean, sir, about?
It's a whole set of data. Like you have almost everything what you require. It means you can directly assume, predict what will be the answer.
Yeah, class of the data or whatever you are trying to describe. Let's say car. Now it could be also different, but let's say car. So all the cars in the world becomes my population. Makes sense? But then I say no. You know what? Volvo cars. Or let's say Hyundai cars. Or red car. Or automatic transmission car. Okay. So AT basically. These become samples. And of course, sample is a subset of population. You understand the idea of subset and superset? Okay, yeah. So population can be taken as a superset for that class at least. And you could have infinite kinds of samples possible. Okay. Okay. You should know this because in while saying we will kind of keep referring things. And you have to understand we are talking about sample population. Mostly we will be dealing with sample, but you should understand what is a sample and what is a population. Okay. All right. Okay. We will come to Gaussian a bit later, not now. Okay. Okay, go for it. So this is the question for you. Okay. And if you want to record or take a picture, that's fine. Okay. Now there are two groups of students and their individual IQs is given. Tell me, which group is smarter? And how will you try to prove it? That's the question.
The mean
average. Okay. Because if you try to compare student by student, it's not gonna work really. It's gonna be a very tricky process. Okay. So you think average might work here. Okay. So go for it. You can use a calculator. Just calculate the average in both the cases. Everyone. Calculate the average and tell me how much different they are. You can use the calculators on your phone. You don't have to like write and calculate. Sorry. What are the answers here?
The first one average is 110.5.
110.5. Okay. What is the second? 105. How much? 105. Second one. Okay, can you just recheck? Because this should not be this much. Anyone online? Did you guys get any answer? On it, 10.2 for the first or the second one?
Second one, 110.2.
Okay. All right. Okay. So you see, it's roughly the same. Okay.
Sorry, I
counted
only for
one. Oh no, the whole thing is. Okay. So you see now, roughly they are the same. Although I will tell you, there are other parameters also which needs to be considered. You might need to also consider the variance of the standard deviation, how much it is spread out. But it's a good measure, right? Now this is what I was telling about that budget of India thing. That now imagine this number to be billion numbers. Not possible, right? Even if you see the value, let's say even though you see the income of, let's say, almost billion people in India, you will not be able to understand anything. But then you start to summarize these things. And this is what descriptive statistics looks like. So we will, today's class would be dedicated to understand and even maybe. Okay, and this was your answer, which was correct. Okay. Let's start. Okay, so I want you to code now. Okay. So take out your laptops and also give me a small, I will ask you about a small amount of code, but you have to code this. So people online, you guys can fire up your Jupyters and or Spiders or whatever you want to code in, no problem. We'll be coding in Python, so please make sure you launch immediately. Okay. Mean most commonly is called as average. Okay. How do you calculate average? So many times it is represented by a bar. Okay. Y bar. Okay. So it's a very simple idea. Summation of all the instances of yi, where I could be from 1 to n, and then divide by n. It's extremely simple. Okay. So why don't you guys, and okay, so now, okay, write a program, simple Python program. And my preference would be you guys use NumPy. And do not use np.mean, okay, that's not allowed. You cannot use this. Just barely, it will take one line. So take an array as an input, okay. So take an input of any size, it doesn't matter. You can randomly generate this array. You don't have to even enter things. And just return me the mean value, that's all. Go for it. Write this program and people online can directly paste the code in chat and I can just check it over there, okay? So it's a simple approach. You add and you divide, that's all, okay? Make a function, pass an array, and return the average value. Simple. Just one general tip, while dealing with numbers, go for NumPy most of the times, okay? If it is just pure numbers, there is no need to use Python's list or anything. Just use NumPy, it is much like maybe 30-40 times faster than Python's list, okay? So just use NumPy array, and this will be much, much faster than anything. And you have to write a generic code all the time whenever I am kind of telling. You cannot hard code it for like 10 values only or something. It should be as generic as possible. So whatever input we give, it should be able to accept. You can initiate your array either through direct declaration or maybe you can start with some random integers or floating points, that's fine. And pass that to the function. So start with like a function called def mean. And this should accept an array, okay? So this should be like a NumPy array. Okay, inside you do your coding and you return average value. Okay, simple. Thank you. Did anyone get it? Okay, let's see. Someone has done it. What? Okay. Okay. Because you guys are doing the sum, there is technically no need to run a loop. You have to understand that. Sum will just sum everything, so there is no requirement of running a loop here. Sorry, I said to use NumPy with numbers all the time. So ever you get something completely numbers, always just go for NumPy, okay? Okay, yeah, makes sense guys, correct. You guys got it? Let's see. Rahul, I understand the idea of taking n, but it's not very required. You could have just done it within the mean. You could just pass this len arr directly over there. There is no need to pass n separately. You guys got it? What's the problem? Guys, you need to be like quick with Python now, okay? You cannot expect me to start with Python now. Is there any problem you guys are facing? While we are doing statistics, there would not be much coding. So I expect you, whenever you go home, please keep practicing Python. You cannot leave Python, okay? When machine learning will start, there will be like maybe coding every day. But whatever the time you have with statistics, make sure you are good with Python. Like otherwise, if I have to tell basic functions in Python, that would not be okay. Okay, so. And if you want to revise or something, we have the video series available. Just please revise, but please be good with Python, okay? Otherwise, it's gonna be very hard for you to continue here. Okay, anything else? Okay, cool. I think most people have done it anyways. So it should not be very hard. Like, most people have got this anyways. It's just a simple one-liner. There is no code here, really. Okay, that's all you have to do. And then just pass it somewhere where you are calling. That's all it takes. So anywhere you see this kind of, just two lines. One is declaration, other is the return. It takes nothing practically to solve the problem. Okay, and if you use NumPy, it will be like much faster than your list. So it is we encourage you to use NumPy every time, whenever you are completely dealing with numbers itself. Okay. Okay. So right now, as you might have remember, you can calculate. Okay. Okay, fine. So calculation of mean is really, really easy. Okay, there is no concept here that is very hard to be taught. But is there any problem? Okay, what is the advantage or disadvantage of using mean?
Mean means sometimes person, for example, in case of salary, person is having too much of salary, and other people are having very low salaries. When you compare the average salary, it is maybe comes high.
Yes.
But not necessarily in the average
salary. Yeah, mean is susceptible to outliers. The problem with mean is okay. So advantage is easy to kind of calculate. Okay, you just sum and divide. There is not much computational complexity here. Okay. Problem with mean is okay. Is that it is prone to kind of move or like how do I say? Okay, let me use a better word. It is affected by outliers. How? Let's take example. Okay, so the bar length would represent the salary, okay? So let's say there is a small company and there are just few employees over there, okay? And these three bars that you are seeing that are slightly on top happens to be few of the, let's say, founders. But they also get like marginally better salary. They are not like getting too much, okay? So you tend to get an average value, and let's say the average looks something like this, okay? This green one is the average for you, okay? For all the employees, this is the average, okay? Let's call this average as, let's call this 7 lakhs or something like that, okay? 7 LP. Okay, let's say this is your average for that small company, okay? Now, let's say this company gets acquired or it gets like massively funded, but then the investors realize maybe these three guys are not exactly in the business mindset. So they kind of fire them and then they replace them with people who are really in the business mindset. But then they start giving them practically very ostentatious salaries. Okay. Okay. Now, what will happen to the mean? Okay, even if rest of the 7 or 8 people are still earning more or less the same money, just because now you have 3 outliers, let's say these are like massively too much compared to the what previous was, you understand the average is gonna shift in the higher direction. But does it changes the reality? Now, okay, so the company can make the claim in next financial quarter that our average salaries have went up. Okay, so you have to understand, statistics can be used to kind of describe the truth or kind of hide the truth as well. Both are totally possible. Okay, you need to understand which one to use well. So now if I say our mean salary has went up, it's not really factually wrong, you are correct. But is it the complete information or are they hiding something? They are hiding something because they are not telling you. It is just maybe the top 3 employees or executives who are really getting that much rise. The rest are the same. Okay, rest of them are exactly the same. Okay, so your average is just is going to move to the positive direction. Okay, or kind of a heavier direction. And that is the problem with average. So whenever I see TV debates about per capita income or anything with mean. So many times I ask myself, why? Okay, so, okay, I will come how to solve this. Okay. So I just think like, okay, but concept of mean should not be always used or always thrown around. Okay. Because if you have too many outliers, it would have moved in the other direction, but still it doesn't, or it might not be saying the truth about the actual population. Okay, so even just few outliers, if they are vastly different, they can just move the whole mean in the third direction. All right. Okay. Hey, guys, please come on time. Like, it's like it's too late. Yeah, I know. Even I was late when I started on time. But okay, have a seat. If you had to think about mean, is kind of a balance point, guys. Okay, in physics, did you guys ever solve these kind of problems? You must have. In 11th, I have solved it, so I remember this. Right? Okay, what is the issue here? So these kind of questions are asked to us. Like, they will put weights on different positions and they will ask, where should be, okay, or center of mass. Center of mass is actually a very good question. So in mechanical, you guys must have solved this kind of problem. You would have an uniform body, and then you would have to integrate and you would have to figure it out where the center of mass is, because based on that, if you apply the force directly on the center of mass, it is much easier to move the object. If you apply somewhere here, the torque will get involved. And basically, rather than translational straight motion, you will have a circular thing, which you may not want. Okay. Whatever. Mean is that, basically. It's a balance point where weights or counterweights are balanced. Okay. Sorry. So if I give you, like, okay, rather than this, I give you a much simpler problem. Let's say there is a small beam, okay, and I put 10 kg here, 10 kg, and 5 kg here. Okay, where should you put a pivot so that it doesn't rotate? Oh, sorry, this whole thing is 1 meter. This length is 1 meter, okay? So where should I put a balance point or a pivot like this so that it is perfectly balanced and it doesn't move? Exactly. If it was exactly 5 kg, 5 kg, you should have put it exactly in the middle. But cause it is 10 kg, now the idea is to counter this torque, this torque has to be equal. Okay? And torque is what is torque's equation? Sorry, what?
Force into perpendicular distance.
Very good. Force into perpendicular distance. So let's call it R. Actually, it's usually a vector, but direction is also not. Okay, fine. So this is your torque. So the idea is this torque and this torque should match in magnitude. Direction would be opposite. And they will just balance itself out. Okay. So the idea is at 3.33, 1 by 3 basically, or 0.33, you will have to put a pivot here. On that exactly it balances out, otherwise it will just flip. Okay, mostly in the 10 kg direction. Okay, that's how you imagine. 0.75. No, 0.75 can't be. Do the mass, it will come to 0.33 and 0.67.
Okay? Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, that would have been when you would have like a 3:1 ratio, then that mass is correct, but here 2:1 ratio is there. Okay. So you just basically flip it. That's the simple idea, if you remember. Or you can also do this same mass with multiple of these objects and try to find. But whenever you might have done this idea, you must remember, if you put a heavier object on one side, this pivot or this center point kind of shifts in that direction. That is a very good representation visually, if you want to understand. And that what is the problem is with the mean. That if you put a balance, a heavier thing or outlier, it tends to start to move in that direction, okay? And with large population, that might not be the truth for rest of them, but just cause a few, it might just move up, okay? Or move down, reverse is also possible. Maybe few people have started doing really very, very bad, and that can bring down the whole average. Both are totally possible. Okay, all right. And this is the whole problem. Mean can be badly affected by outliers. Outliers means data points with extreme values, unlike the rest, which is not equal to rest. And basically as a central tendency, and remember these mean, median, modes are called something called central tendency. Central tendency of data. Okay. Now, if you put Bill Gates or some other billionaires here, they just tend to shift the mean, maybe from here to here. And you might think your economy is doing better or something, but it might not be true for everyone. Okay, so how to counter this? Intuitively, how would you counter this? Now, if you know mean has a problem which gets affected by the outlier, then what?
Mean mode.
Now, but if you have a continuous value, you cannot solve this problem. Mode is good for categorical or
median.
Median, very good. How does median works? Sorry?
It's increasing or decreasing.
Yes, first, median. In case of median, you have to remember, you have to rank them in order. Basically, it means sorting. Okay? In Python, you can use sort or sorted function. The point that divides the distribution into two equal halves is called a median. Okay? So, let's say, now you have to sort them either into ascending order or descending order. Okay? And based on that, and again, either they will be equal or they will be greater than each other. Okay? Whichever is the middle point, that becomes your median. Okay? So, when data are listed in order, median is the point which 50% of cases are above and below. Okay? It is also called the 50th percentile. Anyone knows what a percentile is? Sorry? Anyone gave like a gate or a cat exam? No? So over there you get your marks, but basically you get your percentile.
With reference to the
scoring
highest,
how do you calculate? Okay, tell me, how do you calculate percentile? Okay, so I remember like one of my gate exams which I gave long back ago. So now gate is separated by branch. Okay, gate is not common for us. Mechanical is different, CS is different, that's why. So in CS, let's say in 1 year, although this might not be correct, but let's say 250,000 people actually appear. So this number is who people who came that day, not people who just filled the form. So this is something you can believe in. Okay. And then they will give you your AIR, okay, All India Rank. And they will tell your maybe marks. Marks will also be given there. But what is published or something is not. So now you're not talking in terms of percentage, you are talking in terms of percentile. So I remember like a lot of people didn't understand. So I gave that in my fourth year of my undergrad, okay? And I got like something like 98 point something. It was slightly higher for a lot of people. And they didn't understand. I'm talking about percentile. They were like, how could you get like 98.7%? So they were thinking out of 120 marks, he got like 98.7% mark. That would like practically make you a topper. I was like, no. It's a percentile. I did not get that in a percentage terms, okay? So they could, a lot of people didn't understand what percentile is. Okay, fine. If you know the total number and if you know your own AIR, how would you calculate your percentile? And AIR, the concept of AIR, All India Rank, is it is already ordered. Okay? Rank to palace ordered, you know? Now, what? So how would you do it? Tell me.
AIR divided by
the total. 9. उससे तो और अगर मेरी ए आर बहुत हाई है 1000 तो और खराब कर दोगे ना दोनों से रिवर्स या लेट्स टेक द टोटल नंबर व्हाट एवर यू नो सब्सट्रैक्ट योर ए आर एंड देन डिवाइड बाय द सेम एंड दिस विल टेल यू बेसिकली इट जस्ट टेल्स यू लेट्स से माइन इज 98.3% इट जस्ट टेल्स अस दैट इन अ ऑर्डर्ड वर्ल्ड इफ सारे इफ ऑल 250,000 पीपल गॉट ऑर्डर्ड I was ahead of 98.3% people who attempted that CS gate exam. Okay, that's what percentile means. Okay. So exactly the 50th percentile is called the median. Okay. So remember, how do you calculate median? First, if data is not sorted in Python, and you will have to code it, you will have to sort the data first. Sorry, sort X. X can be an array. And then the middle value. Now, middle value can be thought through the index basically. That you get to know the index or the length and divide by 2. Although there is some complexity still. But the middle value is median. But the very first problem you will run in is middle value is a good idea when you have total of odd numbers. No, odd. So, agar 11 numbers ka array hai. Then, if I just sort it out, then sixth number is median. It's very easy to think. What about 12 numbers? now there are basically two numbers, but median is a single result. So how do you get the median value? So अभी ऐसा होगा कि जो sixth and seventh है, sorry seventh. अब क्या करोगे इसका? इन दोनों का average करोगे. और basically divide by two. So basically you add this sixth plus seventh number and divide by two. That is your median. Can you guys code it? Everyone. Rashma, it's not six. I hope you understood that it was about the numbered coefficients. Okay.
Yes, it is the index number.
Oh, what is that? I understand. Okay. Yeah. So go ahead and code a median code for me.
Yeah.
Okay. Just a little twist. Just a little twist. Let's see how people can. If you are not allowed to specify odd and even. Explicitly, मतलब if else करके case करके मत करना सोचो. एक single line या one or two statements में solve the whole thing. Guys, you need to keep your phone in silence. Okay. All right. So do not specify separately for one case for even and for then for odd. वो बहुत simple हो जाता है, उसमें कुछ है नहीं जरूर. Go ahead and solve. Again, take an empty array itself. Okay. How do you solve this? In Python, you have a sorted function, so don't start making your own sort function. Just pass the array and it will sort it, okay? So don't do any kind of initial, start making your sorting function. So first, define your function. Pass an array A. First, make sure it is sorted, okay? Without that, you cannot find it. Now the trick starts. How would you solve for this? And of course, you should get the length because that will be important. Let's say length L or something, or N, whatever you want to. It's okay. Okay, you get the A length, and now you have to just return something. You have to just return something. Okay. So how would you return the median value? नहीं डायरेक्ट करोगे तो पॉइंट ही खत्म हो गया ना, फिर तो क्यों ही कर रहे थे मेहनत लाइफ में, सिंपल ही करना है तो बाद में इनॉग्रेट, दैट्स व्हाट यू विल डू, बट आई जस्ट वांट यू टू कोड दिस योरसेल्फ सो दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ मीडियन वर्क्स. बाद में यू कैन यूज np.median थ्रू आउट योर लाइफ, नो प्रॉब्लम. नो इंटरव्यूअर इज गोना बी लाइक हैसलिंग यू की खुद से कोड नहीं कर सकते, दैट्स नॉट गोना बी अ कंसर्न, बट एटलीस्ट यू विल गेट अ अंडरस्टैंडिंग इफ यू कोड इट राइट नाउ व्हाट इज हैपनिंग हियर. Anyone made a progress? Any success, guys? You just have to select the middle number. I don't see what's the problem. Okay, let's see. Oh, okay. Come on, you guys need to think a bit hard. Without specifying, explicitly specifying even an odd case, can you guys not solve this? Okay, let me ask you a question. What are these two functions, if you remember? Yes, these are rounding, but how do they do work? Okay, if I put 7 here and 7 here, what is the answer? 7, very good.
1, 10.
What?
1, 10.
1, 10. For which? Achha, you just took the hard-coded one. Anyway. No, you could have taken anything. It doesn't matter. Okay, wait. Show me your code because I'm more interested in that actually. How did you just solve that? So where's the median? That's a mean code, right? Where's the median? Guys, you have to solve for median right now, not for mean. Okay, what about 7.2? What would be the answer then? C, 8, and floor would be? 7. Does this give you any idea how to solve the problem? Because, think about it. If you take a length and divide by 2, if it is an odd length, okay, 13 by 2 would be 6.5, right? Agar is pil floor or ceiling apply kiya, to kya hoga? You will get two values. But if you apply something on 14, then 7 return hoga. Us pil floor ceiling karoga, so same hi aega. Now you are getting how to solve the problem. Just try with floor and ceiling, and you will solve this problem very easily. Did anyone solve it? Basically, after the sorting process, you have to get the elements which are in that array, and you want to get the middle value, right? So a simple idea is what? Let's say n is len of A. Okay. So it's color colors.
Index.
Sorry?
Index.
Ah, that's what, no, not index divide. Okay, so all this operation will happen inside, okay? So if you are understanding that, then you're in correct direction. Okay, let's take an example. A is 10 right now, okay? Okay. So yahan pe kya, how many values will come in for median candidate? So median 2 values, right? Because it's an even number. Now len A is 10. So you basically have to slice this properly. So from where to where?
Len of 8, len of 4.
Sorry, again.
N of
4. No, you cannot hard code this. You can't hard code things. What if it is 20 then? What if it is 2000? You can't hard code. I have told you to make code as generic as possible. You cannot like, okay, I will direct choose n by 4. You have to find out mathematically or programmatically. So, now what? So, okay. What is the median value?
No, average of mean.
Ah, so where did you do the average?
Okay.
Guys, it's not very hard. Or you can, if you want to do it, means you can. Although your code is still not correct, okay, because you still have thought it as only even problem. What about or?
Or also, I'll get only one. Floor and ceiling, I'll get the same.
No, you will get the same value, but it will return two, right? So basically, you want to do the separate average and everything.
Yeah, 124.
Okay, fine. Then it's okay. Ideally, what I would have done, you already have defined your mean function, right? What does mean function takes as input? An array. So why don't I just pass the numbers as an array and the mean function will take care of it? Which you can hard code it, there's no problem. But I'm just telling you can be exceptionally smart how to solve this problem. Okay. So now think about it. Okay. I have to pass what inside? Basically, mujhe bas a se values nikalne dene hain aur kuch karna nahi. You know the slicing operation, how it works? Okay. Fine. करना कुछ नहीं है, यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल हाउ टू जस्ट सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम. फ्लोर एन इज लेन ऑफ ए, ओके, पहले ही मैंने इसे डिफाइन कर लिया, चाहो तो आप डायरेक्ट यहां पे लिख भी सकते हो, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम. फ्लोर व्हाट, अब इसे इतना जनरिक रखना है ऑड इवन खुद से सॉल्व हो जाना चाहिए, यू डोंट हैव टू डू एनीथिंग हियर. सो टेल मी, सॉरी, अरे वो तो हो गया ना, n है ना, क्यों कर रहे हो उसके लिए. n plus 1 divided by 2 c but इसे सॉल्व नहीं होगा प्रॉब्लम, आपको एक और प्लस 1 डालना होगा. बट इफ यू डू दिस राइट, चलो अभी बताओ रैशनल, हाउ डिड आई जस्ट सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम. Does this solve my problem? Yes or no? पहला क्वेश्चन ये है. यहाँ पे जस्ट जानने के लिए sort function has already been applied on A. So ये मत बोलना कि अभी sorted नहीं है. Did I solve the problem? Yes or no? कैसे? How did I solve it? Okay.
So,
yes. So mean function already defined है ना? उसको सिर्फ array चाहिए होता है. तो बस खुद से hard code करने की जगह. You have to think about reusability of code a lot. जब सेपरेट मीन फंक्शन ऑलरेडी बना लिया था तो फिर से आप मीन एवरेज क्यों कर रहे हो, उससे करने दो उसे. अगर एक ही एलिमेंट जाएगा तो उससे क्या होगा, डिवाइड बाय वन होगा. ठीक है, हार्ड कोड करने का नीड ऑलमोस्ट खत्म हो जाएगा. ठीक, ओके, फाइन. तो व्हाट, हाउ हाउ इट इज रियली वर्किंग, कैन एनीवन एक्सप्लेन मी दिस दिस स्टेप, हाउ इट इज वर्किंग. आई जस्ट वांट टू सी दैट यू गाइस गेट दिस आइडिया, कैसे वर्क किया इसने. वी जस्ट, आप कोई भी एग्जांपल ले लो, ए को एक टाइम में 12 मानते हैं एंड एक टाइम में उसकी लेंथ, सॉरी, लेंथ ऑफ ए एंड लेंथ ऑफ ए इज 13. सो 12 के केस में हाउ वुड इट वर्क, 12 के केस में दो आंसर आ रहे हैं, मतलब हम मीन को ना बस ऐसे पास करेंगे कुछ मीन और वहां पे एक एरे जाएगा जिसमें मिडिल के टू वैल्यूज होंगे, दैट्स इट. और दूसरे वाले केस में एरे जाएगा लेकिन उसमें सिंगल वैल्यू जाएगा, आंसर तो तब भी आएगा. ओके, टेल मी हाउ डिड इट जस्ट वर्क हियर. Okay. All right. So how did it work? Take the example, 12. Do the maths. Sorry, this is otherwise you want
to be linked to 13
only. Okay, so floor, nini. And so plus 1, wait, hold on. So 12 plus 1, 17. So floor would be?
6.
Floor would be 6 or A6 basically, but causes a slicing operation to 6 till where you want to go? 8. Because 8 is not included. If I just keep it 7, then it will not include 7. So now you are getting this and you are passing this to me. It will calculate. Basically, this will give you what? Middle two numbers will be returned by this, right? If you do this slicing operation, it will return, let's say, whatever the middle numbers are, 106, 109. Okay, let's assume these two are your middle numbers. These two will be passed and then the average is simple, mean you have already done. Okay, cool. What would happen when it is 13? 13 plus 1 is 14. Okay, and divide by 2 is 7. Okay, and both cases are 7, 7, I know. Okay. So, it will become like, okay, na? Pass. So, you will only pass 7. It solves the problem. Without explicitly specifying anything, I solve the problem. So in Python, there is a lot of shortcuts available and please try to use it, okay? Because this is how you we understand that you are proficient with Python. You understand things. If you have to specify everything as if else and everything, then sometimes it feels like maybe you have just started with Python. You are not very good with Python. Because then you, with Python, you tend to come up with these kind of tricks. That it is very easy. This thing. Floor and seal and a slicing operation solve the whole problem. You didn't have to even specify what is what. Just because you understand the principles how it works. Maybe in some other language it was not that easy. But here it is that easy. Okay, just tell me, just asking you, how do you flip an array in Python, NumPy? Or even a string?
Colon, minus one.
Very good. In C, you would have to write like 2-3 lines of code to flip this. In Python, this will get the trick. So in palindrome code in Python is what? That's it. True, false, that's it. Khatam. This is palindrome. If anyone gives you a string, this is the palindrome code. One shot, finish. So Python has a lot of these functions and more you will practice, more better you will get, okay? So meanwhile, again, I'm repeating, more statistics we will still keep covering. You will not have too much coding here, okay? And you will not even get too many coding exercises. But when you go home, please practice Python. Otherwise, you will really struggle afterwards, okay? And it's easy to learn language, guys. I don't find it very hard to understand. Okay, have you understood how median code works? So basically, now you can average it out separately or anyways, it's totally fine. It's totally up to you. You can average it separately. But as you saw, like again, the main logic was just solved in a single line. And that's all it is, believe me. So it is not harder than that. All right. Okay. Now, why to use median? That's the question. Look, median is of more complexity, right? Because sorting just takes a complexity. Even the best sorting algorithms are like n log n. Mean was getting solved in a k time. Because there is no point. No? You just sum it and just divide it. So why would I do something with n log n? Because it has a mathematical advantage in some conditions. Why? Median is basically unaffected by outliers. Okay? Making it a better measure of central tendency, better describing the typical person than the mean when the data is skewed. Okay? So the idea is if you have outliers, but still if you arrange them as it is. So outliers will now be on some extreme end. And because it is already sorted, it would like keep on rising. But let's say again you have some outliers as these green ones. But doesn't really matter. Okay, even now average would have might move, but the median will remain as it is. Okay, so this is the idea that Because remember, median, how did you access? By the position, not by the value. This is the actual difference. Now, if the position of the middle one is as it is, okay, so this is the point you have to understand. So with that company data, I can ask, okay, what is your median salary? And if your median salary was same as it is, then I can catch their bluff that they might have just increased few people's salary. But overall organization is more or less on the very, very same scale, right? That's the case. That's the case in most of them. And this is how even like our government lies to us many times. Like they will talk about mean values time and again. They were like, why they are not talking about the median value ever? Like maybe if you industrialists are earning more money, but what about a common person? Are they also even earning more money? And they are like, yeah, mean increase has happened. What about median increase? Did that also happen this year or not? So this is the part of descriptive statistics that is very interesting for me. Okay. That basically different statistics can be used to fool you or even tell you the truth. Okay. Everyone is on clear on the median part. Because mean and median are like very big parts of discussion even in machine learning time and again. Because then there are algorithms which use mean property. Okay. But it's a very simple question. In an interview, they will ask you that, okay, this data has noise or outliers. How would you solve it? Because you work on a mean principle, right? You just have to tell them, okay, there is a other variant of this algorithm which uses the median principle. And then it is solved. Because median will not be getting affected by these outlier points, whereas mean will be. Okay, and you will see this coming back and again. Time and again, it will come back. So try to remember the difference between mean and median. Okay, and just to let you know, if people do not already know, there is a simple code. You didn't have to do this much. I just wanted you to understand. That's it. Pass that array, done. Okay, simple one liner. There is no problem here. But once you do it in your own head, it is much clearer how things work.
Is there any like mean?
Mean, I just told you, no? Outlier problem. Media is complexity first. You have to sort the data. If it is not sorted, any sorting algorithm in Python or anything, the best ones are O of N log N. So if you have massive data, first of all, this is the cost. You have to sort the data. Mean, you didn't have this problem, right? You just summed them, divided them. That's constant time. That's like K time, O of K, which we don't care about. Okay. But that's not the case in median. First, you will have to sort the whole thing. And then you basically select and divide or whatever what you want to do. But just the sorting is also complex. If you have too much data, you will realize this will cost you. So median has this inherent cost. Again, because you are doing it on a computer, you will not care. But if I just gave you 10,000 numbers and I told you to do it manually, first you will have to arrange all the numbers. And that will waste the highest amount of time. Because then it is very hard to, then it's very easy to detect the middle number. You are like, okay, here is the middle number. That is the easy part. Because in mean, you will at least have to sum and then divide. Here, there is no real mathematical calculation, unless there are two numbers. But the problem is to arrange them. So remember, median has a cost, that is the computational complexity cost. But for most of your computers, it's not a problem. Okay. If you want to check, just if someone is really interested, run your own mean and median code with you already have executed, it should not take too much time. Make your length really big, maybe 10 million length, okay? And do if you have done it by yourself, although NumPy version is extremely optimized, do this time it module, okay? And check the difference, how much time it took. You will see median will take slightly more time. Again, because your computers are powerful, so you don't feel that problem. But you can use time it module right now, or time module, whatever you find, that's okay with me. Use this time module, start and end time, and see the difference. Again, in smaller, you will not feel it. So make really big array, 10 million values or 100 million values, so that it takes some time at least to solve the problem. And try to calculate the mean and median with your code, not with the NumPy code, because that is already very optimal. So you might not feel the difference, but this is how you will feel the difference that, okay, mean calculation was faster for us. median is slightly slower because of that sorting process. Okay. Okay. But in ideal, if it is well balanced, then what should be the mean and median value? Equal or roughly equal. Many times it is not exactly equal, but it is roughly equal. So if it is within like 5% error margin, your data is very well balanced on both sides, upper and lower. Okay, and this will be the test of skewness. Okay. Okay. You can write down this definition if you want to. If the recorded values for a variable form a symmetric distribution, the mean and median are identical, okay, or roughly equal. But in skewed data, the mean lies further towards the skew than the median. Now, skew could be positive or negative. If it is going in the positive direction or higher direction, that's a positive skew. If it went down in this direction, okay. This will be a positive skew and this will be a negative skew. If this same graph was just flipped in other direction, okay. Okay. The idea is median will remain as it is. Why? Again,
position.
Position. If the middle position is still this person, it will remain this person. It's not gonna change. But if you got some extreme values here, the mean value will definitely shift in that direction. Similarly, if it was in negative, the mean value would have been there. But if it is well symmetric in higher and the lower direction, mean and median should be identically equal or roughly equal. Okay. Till 5%, we do not bother too much. Even if it is within 5% of each other, it's okay. But then when you have 10, 20%, 50%, then you really have to start to worry about it. Okay. Because then there is some serious skewness of your data.
Negative skew will be much more better, right? Like it will be towards median.
Sorry.
Negative skew.
Why it will be? It mean will shift in this direction. Okay. So in case of negative, mean might shift in this direction. But just imagine, I just flip this curve in opposite direction. Make this curve like look like this. Okay. Okay. All right. Mean median is clear to you. Okay, simple concept, but very, very important. Okay. Okay, what is mode? Guys, this is all like 10th class, like mathematics. It's not very hard. What is mode? You must have read this already.
Most frequent.
Very good. Now you can use this with individual numbers. It works, okay? I'm not saying it would not work. But usually wherever you have some kind of category or a range, over there mode shows this value. Okay, category like? In your garments, we have like small, size means medium, large, and extra large, so on. Range could be? 1 to 0 to 10. 11 to 20, something like this. Your scores could be in a range, right? Okay, so aap individually ka bhi mode nikal sakte ho, but most of the time it is very, very useful when things are discretized and separated very well. Theek hai? Over there, it really shows its value. So as he said, the most common data point is called the mode. Or what is frequency? I guess you guys know this. Basically, if you make a frequency table, whichever has the highest bars, that is the mode. Okay, so what is frequency exactly? Number of occurrences or repetitions, okay? Occurrences or repetitions. Make sense? All right. So here we have this, and they have tried to sort it, although in mode there is no... you have to make a different kind of hash map, okay? Basically, over there, if you had to solve them, ideally, I would tell you to make bins. Okay, bins are nothing, it's just a range. So maybe for 0 to 10, I make one bin. And then I tell what is the number, how many numbers are between in 0 to 10. Similarly, how many numbers are from 11 to 20. Okay, and basically, we try to figure out the best one. Or it is directly given as category. Okay, maybe like wedge, how many wedge plates and non-wedge. Okay. Or maybe different kinds of, there are different kinds of like garment collections, even shoe size. Sorry, I forgot the best one. Shoe size. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, something like this. In India, for adults, most of the shoes that are sold are in 8, 9, and then it decreases in either direction. Okay. If you go to a store to buy something, let's say if there is a fresh stock, okay, what is the use of mode or frequency tables?
You will get an idea what type of customers are frequently using.
Good. Dekho, if you open a t-shirt company, a new t-shirt startup, okay, and you are like, you know what I will do is, I will produce 2,000 t-shirts. And there are 5 sizes, just where you are going to produce. So, okay, let's say small, medium, large, extra large, extra, extra large, okay. So what you will do? Would you produce 400 of all of those? No. It would be a very bad bet if you do that, okay? Why? Should you do this kind of stuff? No, it's a bad idea. You could read any previous marketing or any document. Sorry, and you will come to know medium and large are the highest sold. So now you need to basically solve this problem. Okay. So when you go to end of the season sale, you will see this problem. So earlier I used to wear like medium size, but now these days I'm wearing large. So I have this problem. Like I go to any end of the season sale, and if I'm slightly late, I will never find my size in the sale item. In fresh stock I can, but in sale items I hardly find. But one of my friend like kind of wears almost like small, he's like very thin. He always finds it. So that's the idea, right? End of season sale is what? It's unsold stock. They just want to get rid of it at 50% prices, right? Even on Myntra or Flipkart, you will see the same problem. You try to buy something which is giving 60 or 80% deals, okay? You will not find your size. You're like, what? 40, 42, what is gone? You try finding 38 or 46 or 48. You will immediately find it. And they will have like 80% discount. But like here. But most of the sizes are 40, 42 or maybe 44, okay? You will not find that. So to have a knowledge of mode is very important. Okay? Mode basically tells you in a category or in a range what sells the highest, or in overall all the category which is the best category, or repeated category. Most people will prefer that category for themselves. Okay, so it's a good idea. Okay.
More synonym mode is frequency.
Sorry. Frequency or synonym mode. A mode is basically highest frequency. Frequency is what? Repetitions. Number of repetition is frequency. Okay, so highest frequency is called mode, but it is totally possible to have more than one mode. Agar there is no repetition, then but then all the numbers are mode. Isliye main bol raha hu, we have taken this examples, yeah, but it would be a very bad example. Isliye that's why I'm telling, even for scores or IQ scores, we should actually have ranges, because if you collect small amount of data and if there is no repetition, then everything is mode. But rather than doing that, classify them into bins from 80 to 90, 90 to 100, something like this. And then you will find the correct mode. Okay. Okay, write down this as your homework. You have to again solve this mode problem. Because mode, I usually take slightly more time to solve. So that's why I'm not giving it in class. Homework. Again. Again, try to generate large numbers this time, okay? Because you want more repetitions, or you can generate ranges. It's totally up to you. Find mode for array of 100 numbers. Either you can directly try to find the repetition in the 100 numbers, or if you do not find too many repetitions, go with the binning approach. So you can tell like, okay, our numbers are restricted from 0 to 50. I will make 5 bins, and then you will tell which category is the mode. Okay. Is the, whatever. Because if you try to do it for every number, and if I just increase your range, maybe we will not find a single number which repeats, and the mode will be all the numbers. And remember, if you have multiple modes, you will have to return the multiple modes. You cannot average them out or anything. You have to tell there are multiple modes and there are them. So be careful with that. Okay. And please use NumPy itself over there. Sorry. Very good. Okay. All right. Okay. And again, mode basically gives us more likely experience than more central experience. Okay. In symmetric distribution, again, same idea. Mean, median, mode have to be same. Okay. But in skewed data, mean and median lie further than the skew, towards the skew than even the mode. So if you want to even add mode, but that's the problem. Mean and median, we usually think in a continuous value set. And mode, we think in terms of category and ranges. So many times you cannot even put them together. But if you can, you will realize mode will might even be closer to median or even more before the median. And mean and median will be more towards the skew itself, okay? But ideally, we cannot usually merge mode with mean and median. Mean and median are mostly for continuous, and mode is mostly for categorical and range data, okay? But yes, this will be true. If you have a symmetric distribution, all three will be the same, almost. Okay, so we covered central tendency, okay? Now in statistics, there are two problems, guys. And hopefully you will understand. There are major two problems that we are always trying to solve. First is uncertainty. What is second? Anyone knows? Variation. Okay, how would you understand uncertainty? We will also reach there. Uncertainty is you don't know. In very simple things, uncertainty is you don't know. It could be, of course, two reasons. One is, there are two. It is undetermined. It might be undeterminable. You might not be able to determine, or you might not have tools to determine. No tools to determine, okay, or maybe it is has been determined but is just unknown to you. Okay, maybe results of your test has been kept there and it has been put on a computer server, it just hasn't been released to you. That's why you are uncertain. And the other things, you there might not be a tool even to determine that, okay. Okay, or the technique, there could be a lot of reasons. Okay, it might be about a precision factor that we are talking about. Okay, maybe you do not have that many sensors in your car to determine everything. Maybe some other car has all the sensors or anything, okay? So maybe you cannot determine. Okay, so these days, you might have, in Ashes this happened. They came out with a smart bowl. Know what a smart ball is? Okay, so in that leather ball, So they usually have a coconut shell inside. You know that? Okay, it is really tautly bound and on that leather is metal. Now they have created a cavity inside and they have put sensors there. So in Ashes, there was a new statistics which was, I'm forgetting, I think it was RIP RPS. Okay, it is for spinners. Okay, although it has a gyroscope and everything. So basically, how much ball turns and how many, because okay, you can still maybe count the speed when it is thrown from this from the very fast red camera, okay, how many frames the ball covers within 1 microsecond or something. You can tell the speed when it was released from the hat, okay, that much is possible. Spin cannot be detected like that from the camera because of the ball's color. You cannot possibly determine the spin. The idea is how many rotations it made in a second. Now that was uncertain and the reason was we didn't have the tools. Now because of this smart ball, they have put gyroscope. Gyroscope is nothing, it's just knows orientation, okay? Based on Earth's gravity, it can tell you the orientation. However many times it takes a 360, gyroscope can record. And that is transmitted over Wi-Fi, some wireless transmission. And the ball is thrown and within a second they show what was the RPS of the ball. So it was uncertain, but because we didn't have the tools. Okay. Other thing is like, okay, you gave your exam, the checker or the teacher has marked it. It's just that you don't have the access right now. After 3 days, you might have, and you will know. These two things are uncertainty. So uncertainty can be solved like by knowing mean or median. Okay. Let's say you got to know mean, median, or mode, whatever it is. Now you have the tools and you are like, okay, average RPS is what for this bowler? Like average speed. Average RPS could become a new standard for spinners. The idea is if your ball is turning more, when it hits the rough ground, it turns more. Okay, so a person like Shane Warne or Harbhajan can get much more turn than other bowlers because it has been found that they can turn the ball much more. Okay. Okay, so that was the uncertainty part. Let's say from the tools or because now the time is correct, you know mean and median no more. The problem starts second one. Okay, where do you use like mean and median or like mean in your real life? You use actually a lot, but let's see how many people can connect. Where do you use the values of mean and median in your real life or mode as well? Just figure out how many people can think about it. Even in cricket, if you watch cricket, there is average speed, average score, and cricketer's test average. I mean, average is everywhere once you start thinking about it. Bowling average and everything, what is not as available, right? That is one thing. In your real life, when you think about average, you must think about it.
Average expenses.
Very good.
Battery life.
Very good. Battery life. Anything else?
Anything which is like your rush and everything.
Yeah.
17 is an average. Average it will take.
Yeah. How much time it takes to reach there? Average time, man. Many times, if you go to buy a vehicle, you will ask about something. What is that? Mileage. Very good. Mileage is a tendency of being average or mean, basically, okay? Because you know, like, because even if road changes or traffic condition changes, if you're just using your clutch more, if anyone uses clutch more, they will know their mileage is going to be less. It's as simple as that. You change the clutch, even in your cars, if you do not have the automatic transmission, if you are the person who likes to use clutch, miss goes manual. But if you are very quickly changing because of the traffic, your mileage will be bad. It's a very simple concept. Okay. Even the temperature is high. Okay. Your mileage will be less. It just happens. Okay. But it doesn't mean that in extreme temperature, it is very extreme low temperature, it is also very high or something. No, it's not the case. There needs to be an optimal temperature or where it works very well. Okay. Anything extreme, lower or higher, doesn't actually improve your mileage. Mileage is actually one of the things you ask and you do not even realize you are asking about something called average. Whenever you go for shopping, mode is in play. Okay, in a shelf, how many packets they are putting or what sizes they are putting up more or how much they are ordering. Maybe they are putting equal numbers, but in the behind the scenes, they might have ordered more t-shirt for large and medium. That is the example of mode. Okay, and whenever you want to handle this kind of problem of any outliers, you will have to solve the mean problem by the median issue, not rather by mean. The problem with median is, unless you do not have the sorted data, you can't solve. Okay, all right. But now things change. As I said, okay, I tell you your mileage is 50 kilometers per liter. Let's say I say this. But you understand, it is not going to be a constant thing, right? It changes and fluctuates a lot. Okay. So that the second part is called variation, okay? And that is the second problem. So first, let's say you solve this. Let's say you solve this problem of uncertainty. Okay, I didn't know, but by now these things, I somehow know some statistics about the data. But the problem is things change, variation. Okay, and we will discuss about variation. Let me check this. Bike mileage. Okay, good.
Yeah, why is this opening?
Okay. The first thing you need to know is range. What is range? Because it will help in divisions and everything. What is the range in mathematics? Very good. Difference between highest minus or lowest. Does this always works? Some days, okay, there are different ideas and I will tell you. For most of the data, this is correct. Okay. But this also has a problem of outlier. Okay, what if the highest is some extreme value and then your range just exceeds, but it is not. Okay, we will come to that solving this issue. Sometimes range are very hard defined. Okay. You might be in a GPA, 10 GPA. Okay. Then it doesn't matter. The range is from 0 to 10. If you are attempting an exam, the range is between 0, if there is no negative marking. The range is between 0 to 100. However the class is, it doesn't really matter. Over there, range is fixed. But when you are trying to ascertain it by the data, then you do highest minus lowest. Okay? Although remember, if you have an outlier, then again it can be a big problem. If in this group some super genius guy comes from 191, you see the problem, what will happen? It will just increase the range. See here. Here they had an outlier kind of student. Okay. And the now range has just increased. Okay. So the fundamental idea is spread or the distance between the lowest and the highest values of a variable. That will give you the simple range, okay? And for most of the problem, that will be enough. But if you get outliers, either in the upper direction or the lower direction, then what will happen? Yeah, it will drastically increase. So how to handle any kinds of these kind of outlier problems? Same ideas, same median idea. You sort the data somehow and okay, so it is called IQR or interquartile range. And in statistics or in research papers, you will see this kind of thing getting used. If you guys didn't take R classes, right? I think in R classes, this is called basically box and whisker plot. Box and whiskers plot. Okay. What it means is, let's draw it with red. This middle marker is median, okay? Okay, now the idea is this data is going from negative infinity till positive infinity. So outlier to maybe be something. If you try to take range, maybe it will be like something like this. You will not like this. Okay. So what you do is we say something called quartile. You know what quartiles are? Okay. Yeah. So 25th percentile is the first quartile. So 0th element say to 25% element is called Q1 or first quartile. Okay. Then from 25th onwards to 50th or median. It is called second quartile. Okay, so IQR has been defined as quarter 3 minus quarter 1. So middle okay. So IQR is nothing, is the difference between Q3 and minus Q1. And basically, that's the middle 50% of the population. So this range is called IQR, that is interquartile range. And this is not getting affected by outliers. Because either whatever you increase and whatever you decrease would not change anything between most of the middle 50% points. Right? Yeah, of course. Percentile, whenever we say quartile, order, there is no other concept here. Okay. Whenever you see the word percentile, it has to be ordered. Okay, so this area that you are seeing, this area, so whatever is here, less than, so what is the IQR here, guys, in this graph? So Q3 ends at 750, and Q1 ends at, so bus, what is the IQR? Basically, Q3 minus Q1, so 750 minus 250, that would be 500. That is IQR here. Yeah. क्यों? Because again think, you cannot really take a range problem here. क्योंकि again I'm saying it will go till positive infinity, it will go till negative infinity. So you can't. Otherwise all of your ranges will start to look like this, and any kind of mathematics is impossible after that. So for natural values we take IQR, and it also if there are outliers it will not usually have any problem. With range again outliers is a big issue, or like in class exam or something it is already defined kya marks to 0 to you will get marks between 0 to 100, so you don't have to worry about the range. But if it is has to be described from data, you have to understand ideally you can get away with range 90% of the times, but when you have some natural data, okay, or some natural phenomenon where it can take extreme negative values and extreme positive values, it's a very good idea to use IQR. Okay. Okay. Now let's start talking about the variation part. Okay. Variance is basically a measure of the spread of the recorded values on a variable. A measure of dispersion. What do you understand by the when I say the word dispersion?
How spread it is.
How far off it has fallen. Okay, so the larger the variance, the further the individual cases are from the mean value, and the smaller the variance, it would be slightly closer. So let me show you by a picture. Okay, fine. Let me draw this picture rather. So okay, there are different points, guys. Okay. Plotted in the space, and somehow you came to know what is your middle value, something like this. Okay. Now, as you can see, this line exactly, maybe it is going close to this point, but this, okay. So you do understand, mean might be a value which might not even be present in the data set. Right? Remember. Mean might be a value which might not actually be present with the data set. You are taking an average, right? If all the numbers are integers, but it's not guaranteed that their average also be integer. So it can be a floating point, it could be something. So same, this line is a very good example if you think about it carefully. That actually this mean line or this line, which let's say is a mean value, is not really passing through any of these points. Okay, but it is the mean. But as you can see, the idea is the numerical sum will come to equal. Okay, that's the idea. Now the idea is, and I will try to explain is as simply as possible. See these blue perpendicular lines I'm drawing. Why I'm drawing perpendicular lines? Because that's the smallest distance. Okay, that's the smallest distance from line. So these things or these individual distances are called deviations. So deviation is what? It's okay. So let's keep it very simple. Y bar. So whenever I write bar, it is average minus y. Or some people do it in terms of x, so you don't have to worry. Okay, that is deviation. So total deviation would be. Sorry. Very good. X bar minus x. ठीक है. Let's put xi here, of course, because I will be going from 1 to n. Okay, makes sense. Okay, what is the problem here?
The variance, like deviation, is higher than.
Problem is much more fundamental. Okay, try to understand. Based on direction, this value can be positive or negative. Okay. Why? One, let's say. Average is 5.5. One value is 10 and other value is 2. Again, this one is constant, right? This formula. So, in 5.5 minus 2, you will get a positive value. What is this value? But what will happen in the other one? Now think, what if the points are really, really very well balanced around each other? So it can happen that if you do the summation of all the positives and negative value with their magnitude, you might come to zero. And you will think, oh, everything is, because let's say, right now it's a 2D data, so it's easy to visualize. You cannot visualize after three dimensions. So through computer, you would not be able to plot this. That's what I'm trying to say. Or sometimes data is not even shown to you. It's like, okay, it's an encrypted array. You do something, but I will not show the data. So you might feel like, okay, there is no problem with data. Everything is on that line, right? Because the other condition, what would have been what? That everything actually lied on the line, same line as well. But how would you determine those two things are different now? Because you are getting final values in. So how would you know that? So this approach doesn't work. If you directly sum them, it will not work. You can be fooled. Make sense? Okay. So how do we solve this problem? There are two approaches. Okay. One is absolute values. What is absolute value, guys? Sum of absolute. Mod. Okay, makes sense. Or sum of squares. Because square term is always positive. Okay. All right. Now in machine learning, I will tell you someday that this is more desirable for some reason. Right now it will be like, this is more costly. I agree with this. This is computationally costly. But with machine learning, you will understand someday that this is more desired to solve the problem. So we will move with this idea. Okay. Okay. All right. But there is a problem. Still, there is a problem. Can anyone tell me? It's a total thing or just sum, but if there are just many more points, it would be a bigger value anyways. Right. So it's a simple idea. Then why don't I just take mean of squares? And this is nothing, this is called variance. You cannot just deal with sum of squares, because if there are just too many points, even if everyone is contributing a bit, but just because there are less than 10,000 points, the overall sum of squares will be a very, very large value. So you have to take a mean value. Okay. And mean value of the sum of squares is called? Mean value of sum or the whole summation is? Basically, that's the variance. Okay. This term is the variance. Okay. What variance represents?
Dispersion.
Okay. But dispersion in quadratic format or squared format. It's not pure dispersion. Try to understand. There would be slight difference. You will see this. Now, what is the problem with variance? If I wanted to write a range, okay, I want to range. Let's say we say now, okay, sir, mileage is 50 plus minus 5, right? Plus minus 5 or plus minus 10. You can based on conditions, okay? Let's say that was supposed to be a variance. No, it depends, okay? So, can you write variance and mean value together? That's my question, mathematically. Let's say mean value is 55 kilometer per liter or something like that. So can you write like plus minus variance? Yes or no? Simple. I hope you guys took some high school physics. Okay. So in physics, what is it ever taught to you? So let me check. Okay, everyone is saying yes. Okay, that's weird. I thought people took high school physics someday. Okay, all right. Maybe it was taught to, maybe it has been taught to you or anything. Meter plus minus, you cannot right click this. It's not okay. You have taken the square term. How can you write them in a single line? This is not adding. You cannot add these two. You understand this part, yes. Right? It's like very basic high school physics. It must have been taught to you. You cannot add like velocity plus this is acceleration. You can't add that. They are of different dimensions. Okay, same is the problem with variance. Because of the square term, because n is not countering the square, okay, that will be a root term. So this is the wrong expression. You can say variance, that's not wrong. But with a mean value, because variance would be of squared dimension, that is not going to work. So you cannot write this. So that term is called standard deviation. And that is nothing. Standard deviation is just root of variance. And if you want to see the equation, it is just this. That's it. This is called standard dev, and in mathematics it is represented by a sigma, and this is why variance is represented as sigma square, because it is just the square, right? And for mean, then you can write maybe whatever the value is, 55 plus minus whatever your value, let's say 2.5, but this needs to be standard dev, not the variance value. Okay guys, you have to be careful with this part. With any kind of central tendency, if you want to, so what we are trying to do is, we are now certain, we have reduced uncertainty, plus we have tried to capture the variation. This much it will fluctuate, right? So it is giving us, like, you want to come to learn way from your home. And I ask you, like, when will you reach here? You are like, okay, ideally it takes 30 minutes, but per day it changes, right? So plus minus 10 minutes. So now you gave me a certainty first, 30 minutes, plus minus 10 minutes, the range for the capture variation. If it is a Monday, I might take 10 minutes more. If it is Sunday, I can reach 10 minutes early, right? It will happen. If you travel, you will see this factor here. So now you capture both of them. But remember, you could not mention variance over this. Because, and plus you will see variance is a really large value because of the square term. Okay, sometimes variance is a really, really big value. You would be surprised, you cannot even write them together. And you should not. Okay. So variance, you cannot put together with any of these central tendencies. Okay. All right. Simple equation, if anyone wants to note it down. Oh, sorry. First, let's see. Okay. So again, required for variance calculation, y bar first. Without you know the mean, you cannot possibly calculate the variance. So first you get your average. Then basically to eliminate the negative sign, I am taking, and you will see some advantage in machine learning, why we are taking the square term. Okay, you can take the absolute, some of the absolutes are also a way to solve this problem. But we are gonna solve this problem by, okay. Now in different books, in some books it is written like, okay. Again, I'm not claiming that only one way is there. Some way bar, average would be first. And in some days, you will be finding that xi minus x bar is there, okay? Doesn't really matter much if you just put the square there. Okay, all right. Because the different books will claim different formulas, but the essence needs to be same. This is called deviation squared as well, okay? So variance is equation. Okay. Now I will try to make you remember something that you might have studied somewhere in physics. Anyone remembers mean squared error? In gaseous properties, there was RMSE and MSE. Okay, basically Brownian motions and everything, you might have to study this, how to calculate how much they fluctuate. It's, I know it might be some slightly old, but RMSE and MSE were taught to you. Okay, so it's not a problem. It simply means mean squared error. So basically a deviation is also called error. In physics or even in machine learning, deviation is same as error. There is no difference between deviation and error. Okay, so variance is nothing, it's a mean squared error. So standard dev is RMSE. One sec. Root mean. Okay, try to remember it like this. or people also call it summer squares and everything. That's fine. Okay. Again, if you wanted to do manually, it will take time. Why don't you guys make a function from it? Okay, keep this in homework as well. You also have to make your own functions. Again, in NumPy, standard and variance have already have their own function, but please, as a homework, make your own functions for variance and standard def. Okay, separate two functions. ज़्यादा कुछ है नहीं. In standard def, you just call variance and you put a root mean square. For standard def, you don't have to do anything. If you have done the correct calculation for variance, you just have to put an under root over there. That's it. That will solve your problem. So write a program to calculate variance and standard deviation. So please create their functions separately and just call them, and you can just print it out. It's not a big deal. But if manually anyone is very happy to do it, this is the mathematics if you will have to do. If this is just the sum of squares, of course you will have to average it out. But you will have to take the first sum of first, so subtract everything, square it, and then sum, and then take average. That would be the variance value. Okay.
So this NumPy might be having a shortcut for variance.
Yeah, everything already has a function.
So, are there standard deviation is what we use
it. You will see. In machine learning, I will show you. MSE is a very, very important tool for us to solve the problems. Okay. I will show you. Okay, first one thing, remember, doing under root is also a complexity. It doesn't look, in computer science, there is nothing free of cost. You have to understand, there is no free lunch theorem. Anything you do will come with a complexity. So if I can solve something without under root, why wouldn't I solve over there? Look, it is good for representation, but you have to understand, after doing summation, first taking, okay, so subtraction is not a problem. Subtraction and the summation is not an issue, but the problem is first you already did a square, okay, for all the terms, added them, and then this one, okay. Now, if you could solve something in this shape already, differentiation, integration, why would you try to do under root? Because that's also a complexity involved, unfortunately. Okay, so someday that you will realize maybe to solve some problems, I can solve on a level of variance itself. I do not need to go in RMSE, okay. And I will show you some mathematical shapes. It will be very clear why it is better than standard error. Okay, but for writing, yes, variance doesn't make any sense. Why would I use variance when I cannot even put it with it? Okay, all right. Now, right now, I do not expect you to understand this because it is a better estimate. Remember this: whenever you are dealing with variance for the whole population, the symbol is like this. Sorry, x bar minus x. Squared by n. But when you are dealing with a sample, it just provides a better measure of, you can see I have used small n here, okay. It just provides a better estimate, okay. We will have a sampling class, I will try to explain over there why it is so, okay. Most of the days in any interview, if anyone asks, just do this, okay. You don't have to worry about anything. So once you have calculated this correctly, variance is extremely easy, okay. But the problem is you cannot really write them with any mean or median value, okay. So for the whole thing, you just perform an under root. Whatever variance you already got, just perform an under root. That will give you a standard error. But remember, with the standard error, because you are doing under root. What is the outcome of under root? Positive and negative values. So usually we just consider positive values. If the variance was positive, we also consider positive, but we just assume that any kind of range when we write, it is always mean plus minus standard error. Okay. But programmatically, you can just take the plus value if you want to. Okay, so what I want you to do is, okay, so the idea is in that second group, or first group, sorry. So to measure the group's tendency, first you figured out, okay, this is the average, but then you figured out how much spread they are. Okay. So can you do it for second group? If I just show you the data. Okay. Average, remember over there, I think it was 11.29. I will just show you the data. Right. Sorry, this is the data. So do the same thing. Give me the same representation and then the class is over. Okay. Give me the representation in. Now, you can do it through your computer, calculator. It's okay with me. No problem. It would be better if you do it with your computer, but it's all right. Even if you can do it immediately with your calculators, go for it. Later at your home, you can solve it through programmatical exercise. And I will share you a notebook where I have implemented everything through simple numbering. So you will come to know all the functions. But if you do it this way, at least it will be in your head for a long, long time, how things really work. Come on, solve this. Okay, this chapter is almost over. So tomorrow we are going to start with linear algebra matrices. So please revise matrices and make sure you are familiar with basic NumPy, okay? Because tomorrow I will make you code even slightly more than today, okay? So please be very, very familiar with NumPy and its functions, how to initiate, how to add, sum, subtract, multiply. These will be very helpful tomorrow, okay? Because tomorrow we are going to cover linear algebra. And ideally, it should not take more than one class. Okay? you guys be able to do it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, guys, so finishing up the session, and you can mention the answer in chat if you want to. And tomorrow we are going to start with linear algebra. Please revise NumPy, okay? It would be important. And whatever the questions you still have remaining, mode, variance, and standard F, try to code them, okay? It's a very simple operation. Don't worry, it's not that tough. And I will upload this on your Google Drive today, okay? So anyone wants to revise or want to check it out, I will upload it on Google Drive.
You will get the link in Google Drive.
Sorry?
You will get the link in Google
Drive. No. Okay. Do you have the Google Drive link already? You just will have to check. You will not get any notification, but I will mention on WhatsApp. But you have to go over to Google Drive and check that it is there. Okay, it will be there. Don't worry. Okay, guys. So, yeah. Oh, sorry, what is the mean? No, it was 110.29. It was already done. Like, how can you get that that one wrong? And if your mean is wrong, of course your standard is wrong. I already know the answer. So look, it was already done. So I thought like people remember that. Okay. Something like forgetting that. 110.2 as something like that was the answer. So that's why even I was like, okay, fine. Yeah, people are mentioning at that time, right? 102.9. Okay, guys, finishing up today's session. We will meet tomorrow for linear algebra. And make sure you finish up these basic programming exercises. And I will also share a notebook where I implemented all of this through simple like one-liners. Numpy, okay? So that at least, because in long run, that's what you will be also doing. You will be not using or making your own function. That's not even advisable here. But just for a practice and just to understand and also for me to be confident about your coding, these basic exercises are required. Okay, so that I know that you guys can code a decent bit of program if I tell you to. Okay, and revise Python because still I see some hesitancy when I say something, people are not very confident what to do. So I will not be teaching you Python. Means if there is some unknown function, I can tell you, okay, this is how you use this function. But I will not be teaching you Python basics. You have to be very, very clear about this with this class, okay? You cannot ask me how to use a for loop. Like, I will not answer that question. So please revise Python. If you didn't have the time, please do it now. Because for statistics will go on for like 2 weeks. Okay, so next week I'm not gonna be here. So even if there is some other class going on, you guys keep revising Python without fail. Okay? Okay, guys, so see you guys tomorrow. And again, 8 a.m., okay? 8 a.m. Bye-bye. Take care.
It's plus or minus 20 minutes.